Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Donna Anderson, and I am here today to introduce you to a new ruler, a new technique that is out there. I love to teach technique. I love to teach new things that are coming up. This is a ruler called a polygon ruler. It is designed by a female engineer who just retired from the government. Her name is Gyleen Fitzgerald. So it's an engineered ruler, not just a straight ruler. I didn't believe it in the beginning when I started using this that it did something more than some of our other rulers do, but it does. This is a very simple tool that will give you four different shapes. It gives you diamonds, it gives you cone shape, it gives you a hexagon, and it gives you a pyramid. All of those shapes go together to make a lot of unique designs. Gyleen has a wonderful book. She has a wonderful website. She is certainly somebody worth looking up. When you use this ruler, you are using it with a 3-inch strip of fabric. I have mine folded in half, and you are simply laying that ruler, which is like this. I have the blue on it just so it doesn't slide so much, on the diagonal to cut diamonds. So I'm going to cut a couple of diamonds for you. Once you make that first initial cut, you never have to cross cut again on your hand. So there's a couple of diamonds, and here's a couple of diamonds. Now, it's the way you use this ruler and how you place it on your diamond that create all the other shapes. So here's my diamond, and I'm doing this backwards, so it's going to be a little unique for me. I am going to try to make a hexagon out of that. I simply rotate my ruler. Can you see it on top of me here? Where I took the diamond and I rotated it. And if I cut these two ends off now, it will create the hexagon for us. So, one, two. Little pieces that come off, you can, and I have used them in other pieces. Because they're all designed and engineered, every piece goes back together again. There's a hexagon, just by flipping that ruler a little bit. That's one of the shapes you need. You need a pyramid. So again, I cut a diamond, and I am going to cut a pyramid by switching my ruler around. Let me show you how I did it. Here's my diamond. I'm going to turn and slide down to the line that says pyramid. Okay. And then I'm going to cut again. The pyramid has two little wedge cuts at the bottom that become incredibly important because the flat edges line up and make it so that you don't have holes when they join. Okay? And then, of course, it's just the straight diamond. Okay, so we've gotten the pyramid, the diamond, the cone, and the hexagon. So there's your straight diamond again. To make the flower on the piece that you see in front of me, over here to my right, it takes six cone flower shapes. It takes one hexagon shape. It will take six diamond shapes to make the flower. Then you join them together with the pyramid shapes. So you're just sewing pyramids together. Now the beauty about this ruler is that Gyleen has designed it so that she has patented a technique called butterfly technique. The Y seam that we used to do. Notice I said used to? I don't do it anymore. Because with a Y seam, you're always leaving the needle dropped down in the pieces that you're joining on your tumbling block, which are your three diamond pieces. So you're sewing your diamond pieces together, and you're always leaving the needle in the fabric and then turning the fabric under the needle on the machine. you don't do this with Gyleen's technique. I'm going to take a hexagon shape, and I am going to take a cone shape to start making my flower. I'm going to put them right sides together, and I'm going to sew my very first seam. I'm over here using a Foff machine that Smith Owen has kindly loaned me, and we're going to see if we can make it work. Okay, let's take a couple of stitches here. All right, get that thing to go up. Up. Up foot, up. There we go. Sew a complete seam all the way across it. See it? Now, normally we would have dropped our needle down and turned the fabric at this point to add another piece. We don't do that with Gyleen's method. We take another cone, and we are going to simply add it to the pieces that we have and sew another complete seam. So I would be adding a cone to a cone. See it? Cone to a cone. I'm going to sew that as a complete seam. So the first one is one complete seam all the way across. My second one is going to give me a cross in the middle of it, and I'm going to have some stitches to unstitch. So let me sew this one together. And notice I'm not pressing in between. You don't need to with Gyleen's technique, because the seams all start to rotate as you start to do your sewing. Okay, I sewed a second seam. It is totally across what I just did. It is a complete seam. What you end up with is pieces that look a little funky. So for the camera, I'm going to show that you end up with an X, and you're going to unstitch the X in that seam. So I am literally going to, I don't know if you guys can see it because it's white light thread. There's an X in there. You need to remove or unsew those stitches. Okay, I'm getting a hum. There goes some, and there goes the other side. I'm not actually ripping them, I'm just loosening them up. You then get a piece that looks at you with the seams coming up. Can you guys see that at all? Okay, so the seams are raised up when it's laying down on you. Can you see that? I'm sure the cameras love that one. Because of the way she has designed the rulers, you line those seams, you bring those seams together like a butterfly. So I'm grabbing my seams and I'm pinching them together like the wings of a butterfly and lining them up. The next seam that I am going to sew is going to be right here. This is typically where we have the needle and we're turning the fabric again. We're making a complete seam. So again, I will go to the machine and I will sew a complete seam all the way across all of those stitches. And what I end up with is a piece that has no hole. You know how you used to fight for that hole? There is no hole in that piece. And then you just continue to make that sewing around with your cones. So I would then right side together again, and I am going to sew that seam right there, complete seam. Come on, there you go. Again, I end up with the X's that I need to pull out. And of course, it always works better when you can see them. And again, I will end up with that same joint that I want to pull together. There are my wings again. I'm going to pull those wings together line them up. Notice I'm not using pins. I'm not slowing myself down. Stick it underneath there and do another complete seam. And you continue on in that method, getting all of the cones to make that sunflower. All from a 3-inch strip. It's so easy, ladies. You just rotary cut them right off. Again, I've sewn a complete seam. I'm going to take my X out. I've removed those stitches. I come up with the butterfly again. There's the butterfly with the wings sticking straight up. I line it up. And I sew that seam again. So again, I'm adding to it. Taking another cone, you do it with all six. Just nice and easy. Sewing a complete seam. And then again, I unstitch. Lay it back out. There's your butterfly again. Grab those two wings, pull them together. Gyleen has managed to take all of the stress of Y seams completely away from us. I did an entire quilt of a tumbling block, which is the diamonds instead of the cones and the hexagon, and had holes in probably 90% of those blocks because I wasn't good at flipping the fabric out underneath. And this has just made my life so much easier. Complete seam. All right, we've got one last cone to go, and of course I don't have one cut. So, oh yes I do, here it is. Okay, one more cone, and then we'll start adding diamonds to it. Gyleen came and talked to the West Michigan Quilt Guild. Several months ago, and she is just on fire for quilting since she is retired. She's written a book, and she's got 18 patterns in the book. And her website has a ton of information of different things that you can do with this particular ruler. I love what she's doing. Again, there's your butterfly seam. I'm grabbing my wings, putting them together, lining it up, and sewing that last seam. To make my last seam, again, I'm going to unsew. Maybe. Okay, and it's gonna rotate, and again, that last seam, all I'm doing is opening up that seam in front of me, bringing them together, and I'm gonna sew that together, and we should have the complete flower. How many of you guys have done tumbling blocks? Okay, did you enjoy the Y seam? Oh no, it's not fun. Okay, well there is my flower. Okay, nice and easy. To build the flower out for the rest of this, you're gonna add the 6 diamonds around it. So I'm going to cut those diamonds by taking my ruler and just setting it on my 3-inch strip and cutting, because it's over, you know, doubled over, I'm getting 2 at a time. It doesn't take real long to cut them. There you go. So those are all cut, well, almost cut. And I'm going to do the same process over for the diamonds, adding the diamonds. I'm going to line my diamond up, like so, and I'm going to sew that first seam completely. I bet you guys are going to get tired of hearing that one, aren't you? But as we all know, quilting is just a process of repeating everything. Now, again, Gyleen does not have you press anything. She is a presser at the end, but it works. It just does. I took an entire class with her, and we sat there and sewed probably 4 or 5 of these entire blocks together, never pressing until the very end, and it still comes out as a beautiful product. So again, unsew those stitches. I'm going to bring my wings together. Going to line them up, and the beauty is that this thing lines up so well. Now, Gyleen would probably put a pin in there, but I don't have time for that. Another seam. All right, didn't quite line that one up, so we're going to go again. Here we go. See how easy it is to start building that out? There's no holes in that. And you just continue on. Now I do, though we don't press, I do make sure that my seam on my diamonds is going out at the tip so that my 2 tips line up together. Okay? That's important. I'm sorry, can you say again? I am starting on the outer tip. What she asks is which way I'm starting to sew. I'm starting on the outer tip and sewing into the Y seam. Yes. Again, you just unstitch a little. Set it back down again. Find your butterfly. Bring your wings together. And sometimes they fight you because you're starting to get more fabric in there now. Just keep working at it until you get them nice and smooth. Line your tips up. And you know that you're always right when you have points that match. Everything on this ruler makes matching points. Whoops. I do like to sew a little quicker than that. Huh. Okay, so I'm just going to keep going around in that process. So, tip out, tip to tip, start on your outer tip, sew in. Back your stitches out. Sounds like a lot of repetition, but it works. Get your wings up. Kind of spread your body in front of you. Pull those wings together. Line it up. Sew that next one. My tips are lining up. See it? It's developing. I have lots of fun with trying different fabrics and the way they go together. If you look at Gyleen's books, she has some very unique fabric combinations and color combinations that really shows that she's into the different part of quilting, the different fabrics. I think she took a damask tablecloth because she liked the fabric and put it into a quilt. It worked. I think we're all learning to go to a different way of fabric. Okay, I think I have one more to go maybe to get this flower done. Nope, two. Push that point out, hand press it down, sew from the out to the in. Did I show you guys how to make the hexagon with the ruler?
Yes.
I did? Okay. Unstitch. Wing it out. Bring the wings together. Line them up. And stitch. It's developing. One more. Maybe I'll get to show you a pyramid in there. I don't think we would ever have been able to sew this together that fast with the old technique of the needle in the fabric. Yes, hexagons, diamonds, any of them. It's always the wing technique. That's her patented technique of getting rid of the whole force, is bringing the butterfly wings together. Doesn't matter what shape you're using, you're doing the same thing over and over again. All right, last one. Pretty fast little flower. Okay. So what she does in this particular pattern is she makes two flowers and she joins them together with the pyramids. Okay, so if you can see here, let me pull it out a little bit. Here are your pyramids. Okay. So she's sewing four of them together in this unit, adding them to the diamonds, sewing four of them together to finish the other side, and then you join those units together. Let's see if I can get a couple pyramids together for you. Let me count a couple that are in a different color just so you can see the difference. All right, so you can take a pyramid from a diamond simply by lining. All right, wait, I'm confused here. Hold on, here it goes. When I first started doing Gyleen stuff, all I did was cut the diamonds, and then I cut my everything else out of my diamonds. So you're, again, lining up your edges. Now this is just a straight sew, ladies. This is not a pyramid or a butterfly technique on this one. So let's see, did I get one, two, I need this one, and I turn him this way. So all I did was line up my flat edges again, and I'm making the three across. Okay, and then I would add one more on top. And that makes my first pyramid unit. Okay, so there's one of my pyramid units to put into my flower. So he would join down in to one of those sections. And you would continue to make another set, add the two, and then join your pieces together. Gyleen has some wonderful patterns along with her books. You don't have to buy the entire book, but she gives you great directions in there, how to join them together, how to make the different products come together. You can sew a grandmother's flower garden quilt with nothing but her hexagons. You could do a tumbling block. Now, unfortunately, this is all the same fabric, but it's three diamonds. Again, sew your diamonds together, bring your wings together, line them up, sew that last seam. Let me sew that last seam for you, and you'll see you've got a tumbling block.
Do her diamonds come in a variety of sizes?
She has two sizes. The question was, do they come in a variety of sizes? She has two sizes, this small one, and then she has about an 8-inch pyramid. So you're going to get your quilts done a lot faster. They're great for doing baby quilts, any size. There's your tumbling block. See it? Okay, that's just straight out of a diamond. But if you try to do that technique with a different ruler where we're having lines to line up with, because those lines shift all the time, it's not as accurate. You saw how quick this went together, how easy it was. It's just simply because it's designed for all the pieces to work together. So I love Gyleen's techniques. I love her work. Her website is www.colorfulstitches.com. She has a blog as well that will tell you all sorts of different things and give you different ideas every day. She's just a dynamite lady, and I really, really highly suggest, if you like new rulers, new technique, that you add this one to your collection. Yes, we all have collections of rulers, don't we, ladies? She's just perfect. She really is perfect, and her work is so accurate. Thank you.